Before proceeding, please make sure to subscribe and turn on the bell icon for upcoming videos. This video will be about differential arches and their derivatives. Before moving on to this video, I suggest you watch my previous video where I have done a very quick review on the basics of embryology like fertilization, gastrulation and urination. So, let's begin. This will be the frontal or ventral view of an embryo at week 3. The developing embryo will have two ends. The head or the cranial end, and the tail or the caudal end. The embryo will start folding at two planes or axes, the craniocaudal axis and the lateral axis. And just to mention here that this will be the neural tube lying inside the embryo. At week 4, this will be the folded embryo from a lateral view. Here will be the stromodium, the cardiac bulge, and the neural tube. Lateral to the stromodium and just above the cardiac bulge, 6 pairs of well-defined outgrowths called the pharyngeal arches develops by week 4. These pharyngeal arches are a proliferation of mesodermic germ layer infiltrated by the neural crest cells. If we make a cut at the embryo along the pharyngeal arches, this will be the inside view of the pharyngeal arches, which are seen as pairs on lateral sides of the embryo. Now let's zoom in this area and look at the anatomy of these arches. These pharyngeal arches are named as arch number 1, arch number 2, 3, 4, and 6. The fifth pharyngeal arch does not exist in humans. It either disappears once it's formed or it's not formed at all. On the outer aspect, the pharyngeal arches are separated from each other by the pharyngeal clefts, also called the pharyngeal grooves. The pharyngeal grooves are 4 in number. Let's say the first pharyngeal cleft lies in between the first and second pharyngeal arch. From the inner aspect, the pharyngeal arches are separated by small concavities or depressions called the pharyngeal pouches. The pharyngeal pouches are also 4 in number. Together, the pharyngeal arches, the pharyngeal clefts, and the pharyngeal pouches makes up the pharyngeal arch system. And each one of the constituent of the pharyngeal arch system will give rise to different structures of the head and neck. Each arch at its central core is fed by an artery, a nerve, and a cartilage. The nerve supply of the first pharyngeal arch is the fifth cranial nerve or the trigeminal nerve. Facial nerve innervates the second arch. Third arch innervated by glossopharyngeal nerve. Fourth arch innervated by vagus nerve. And sixth arch is innervated by the recurrent laryngeal nerve branch of the vagus nerve. The cartilage of the first arch is called the Meckel's cartilage, and that of the second arch is the Reichert's cartilage. The rest of the arches do not have specific names for their cartilages. If we look at the germ layers that makes up these pharyngeal arches, the outer wall of these pharyngeal arches is made up of ectoderm. Endoderm will make up the inner wall of these arches, and their central core is made up of mesoderm. Also, not to forget here that the mesodermal core will be invaded by the neural crest cells from the neural tube. Now let's look at the derivatives of the pharyngeal arch system and talk about the derivatives of the grooves and the pouches first. The first groove and pouch are involved in the formation of ear structures, such as the external auditory meatus, the primordial tympanic cavity, and the eustachian tube. The part of the arch left in between the primordial tympanic cavity and the external auditory meatus will eventually become the future tympanic membrane. The second, third, and fourth grooves are obliterated by the overgrowth of the second arch. This area will eventually become the future cervical sinus. The second pouch is also obliterated by the development of the palatine tonsil, but a part of it remains as the tonsillar fossa. The third pouch expands dorsally and ventrally into two compartments. Its dorsal component will give rise to the inferior parathyroid gland, and its ventral component will join its anatomic counterpart, forming the thymus gland. The third pouch also expands dorsally and ventrally. Its dorsal component will give rise to the superior parathyroid gland, and its ventral component will form the ultimobrachial body, which will later on give rise to the parafollicular cells of the thyroid gland. Let's look at the derivatives of the arches now. Each arch will have a muscular derivative and a skeletal or cartilaginous derivative. The muscular derivative of the first arch will be muscles of mastication, tensor muscles such as tensor tympani and tensor veli palatini, mylohyoid muscle and anterior belly of digastric are also examples of the first arch musculature. The skeletal derivative of the first arch is mainly the maxilla and mandible. Ear bones such as malleus and incus are also derived from the first arch. The first arch musculature will be innervated by the nerve of the same arch, which is the trigeminal nerve. The muscular derivative of the second arch are the muscles of facial expression, the stapedius, stylohyoid, and the posterior belly of the digastric muscle. The skeletal derivative of the second arch are the stapes, the styloid process of the temporal bone, and the lesser horn of the hyoid bone. The muscles of the second arch are also innervated by the nerve of the second arch itself, which is the facial nerve. The muscular derivative of the third arch will be the stylopharyngeus muscle, and its skeletal derivative will be the greater horn of the hyoid bone and part of body of the hyoid bone. And again, the third arch musculature will be innervated by the nerve of the third arch itself, which is the glossopharyngeal nerve. The muscular derivative of the fourth arch will be the pharyngeal and the laryngeal muscles, and its cartilaginous derivatives are the laryngeal cartilages. The muscles will be innervated by the nerve of the fourth arch, which is the vagus nerve. Muscular derivatives of the sixth arch are the same as the fourth arch, with the exception of the cricothyroid muscle. Its cartilaginous derivatives are the cricoid, arytenoid, and corniculate cartilages. The muscles of the sixth arch will be innervated by the recurrent laryngeal nerve branch of the vagus nerve. If you think this video was helpful, please like this video and give a subscription. If you have got any questions or suggestions, you may write them down in the comment box. Thank you for watching.